John Brack is one of the most important Australian artists of the late 20th century. He was born here in Melbourne in 1920, and his early training he undertook here at the National Gallery School between 1938 and 1940. He was enlisted in the army between 1940 and 1946, and following his discharge he continued studying at the National Gallery School until 1949, when he commenced work here at the National Gallery as assistant framer, and then following that as art master at Melbourne Grammar School. He was an influential educator, and parallel with his career both as a teacher and as a lecturer, he maintained his painting practice. One of Brack's earliest paintings, The Barber's Shop, was acquired by the NGV in 1953 and was an important early success for him as an artist. Of course, in 1955, he painted the, iconic work, Collins Street 5pm, which was acquired in 1956. It's a work that captures the caustic starkness of the mundane aspect of life in the city, and I think that's one of the sort of identifiable features of his painting, particularly of this time, where there's a moodiness. The greys and the browns really, capture the bleakness of city life, I suppose. In a similar vein, there's the wonderful painting The Bar, which alludes to Manet's The Bar at the Folies Bergères, but in Brack's case, it shows the 6 o'clock swill, which is that sort of, unique Australian event where at closing time, people would gather to the bar and try and drink their beers as quickly as possible. I think my favourite painting, though, of Brack's is a smaller work. It's called The Car, and it depicts a family travelling on a holiday. You can see the sort of the landscape through the window, and the kids looking out from the back. And what I like particularly about that, I think I can identify with. My mother had the same car. It's a Triumph Mayflower, and for me that captures the mood of the times, and also for me a very personal experience of family holidays and things like that. I think more than any other Australian artist, Brack's able to capture that ordinariness of life, but do it in such a way that gives the viewer this sort of quite unique snapshot of life at the times.